A House committee took up the bill that would make it illegal to hold your cell phone while driving. Kent Erdahl is live with what's next. Kent?
Well, Julie, first of all, the goal of this bill is really, like you said, to get phones out of drivers' hands no matter what. That even means while you're making a call, unless you have a hands-free device or use your speakerphone. Now, right now, the sentiment around here is that there's more bipartisan support for this law than ever, and it's largely thanks to those families who are closest to this issue.
The Minnesota State Capitol has been a frequent stop.
Too many to count.
For Wisconsin resident Tom Geltz.
The first one this year, but it's probably half a dozen last year.
As a safety consultant, he's spent 30 years discouraging employees from distracted driving.
Making sure that when they're driving for work that they're being safe.
But this trip to testify in support of a hands-free law isn't work-related. It's personal.
It's mainly going to be that I'm the father of Megan and her unborn child that were killed by a distracted driver.
Because his daughter's crash happened in Minnesota, Tom and his wife Melissa have joined with other families of distracted driving victims at the Capitol the past 2 years, pushing for a hands-free driving law.
I really think it's time. It's time for us to catch up with technology.
And this time, he and others are hoping the third year is the charm.
It won't completely eliminate the problem, but it will help. And maybe if we save some people's lives, then it's all worth it in the end.
The Minnesota Safety Council says hands-free laws have saved lives in the 16 states where they've passed, averaging a 16% drop in fatalities within 2 years.
And if we can get a 16% decrease in the year that follows implementing hands-free, that'll be about 55 people whose deaths would have been prevented.
Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed? Motion prevails.
Though the bill has passed its first hurdle in the House, the families of victims know there are many more to go.
All we're trying to do is we're trying to save people's lives in the state of Minnesota. It's already too late for our families. We're trying to save you.
Now, as I mentioned, Tom is looking forward to this because of the bipartisan support. We also have a governor who said he'll sign this law, but there are still several hurdles left. The bill right now in the House will go to another committee before it can go to the floor for a vote. Meanwhile, the Senate is expected to take up its own bill tomorrow morning. Julie.
All right. Thank you, Kent. A reminder, you can join Care 11 in being part of the solution to end distracted driving. Take our Eyes Up pledge by texting the words Eyes Up to 25543.